Hello and good day, welcome to our YouTube channel God's Promises and Todays. Video will be Book of Psalms, Chapter 79. Let's get started now. Psalm 79 is a psalm of lament written by Asaph after the destruction of Jerusalem by the Babylonians. It is a prayer for God's mercy and for the restoration of the city of Jerusalem and the people of Israel. The psalm can be divided into three parts, a cry for help, a confession of sin, and a prayer for restoration. The psalm begins with a cry for help, as the psalmist describes the destruction of Jerusalem and the desecration of the temple by the Babylonians. The psalmist pleads with God to have mercy on his people and to deliver them from their enemies. He asks God to remember his covenant with Israel and to avenge the blood of his servants. In the second part of the psalm, the psalmist confesses the sins of his people and acknowledges that their destruction was a result of their disobedience to God's commands. He asks for God's forgiveness and mercy, not because they deserve it, but because of God's great name and his reputation among the nations. Finally, the psalmist pleads for restoration, asking God to turn his anger away from his people and to show them his favor once again. He asks God to restore the temple and to gather his people back to their land. The psalmist ends with a prayer for God to deliver his people from their enemies and to show his glory to the nations. The teaching application of Psalm 79 is that sin has consequences, but God is merciful and forgiving to those who repent and turn back to him. The psalmist acknowledges the sins of his people and their need for God's mercy and forgiveness. This serves as a reminder to Christians today to confess their sins and turn back to God, knowing that he is merciful and forgiving. The psalm also teaches that God is faithful to his covenant promises, and that he will one day restore his people and show his glory to the nations. This gives hope and comfort to believers who may be facing difficult times, knowing that God is in control and will ultimately bring about his plans and purposes. Obrigado por nós, por favor, compartilhe conosco o seu capítulo bíblico favorito, abaixo na seção de comentários. Não se esqueça de curtir e se inscrever, isso realmente ajuda nosso canal a crescer. Espero vê-lo de volta aqui para o nosso próximo vídeo. Cuide-se sempre bem!